Hey, what's up guys? In this video, we're gonna talk about else if ladder in Java. Else if ladder is arrangement of if and else if block that they form a ladder like structure where every else if has its own condition checked one after another in a sequence. And all these conditions are checked from top to bottom. Now we're gonna take a closer look at the syntax of else if ladder in Java. The syntax of else if ladder is, first you have the if keyword, and inside the parentheses we write the condition, and after that a block of code. Right after the if block we can have the else if block with the keyword else space if, and after that inside the parentheses we write our condition and also a block of code. And we can have another else if block with another condition and another block of code, and this else if ladder goes on as many we want. And at the end we have the else block, which is also called the default block. So all of these conditions are checked from top to bottom in a sequence, and whenever any one of these conditions become true, then the corresponding block of code is executed, and after that the control exits the else if ladder. When none of the conditions are met, then the else block at the end will be executed, and this is also called the default block. The else block at the end is optional. We do not necessarily be writing this. So the syntax of else if ladder is, first we have the if keyword, and inside the parentheses we have the condition and also a block of code. After that we have the else if keyword, and inside the parentheses we have a condition and also a block of code. And the else if ladder goes on. We can have as many else if block we want in our program. At the end of the else if ladder we have the else block, which is also called the default block, and this is optional. Now we're gonna take a look at one example program and try to understand the else if ladder in detail. So in this example program we try to print the grade of a particular number. So we have first created a class test, and inside the class we have created the main method, and inside the main method we have a double variable x and assign it the value 7.5. After that we have the else if ladder. First we have the if keyword, and inside the parentheses we have the condition. The condition is, if the value of x is greater than or equal to 9, then we are going to execute the code and print the string O onto the console. Similarly, after the if block we have the else if block, and which has its own condition. The condition is, if the value of x is greater than or equal to 8, then it gonna execute the line of code and print E to the console. Similarly, we have all these other else if ladder, and they have their own condition, and they all print different grades onto the console. And at the end we have the else block, which is also the default block. When none of the conditions are met, then the default block is executed, and which is going to print if or fail onto the console. So let's go and compile and run this program. So first we are going to compile this program with the command javac test.java. So we have successfully compiled the program. So now we are going to run this program with the command java space test, and the output is A. This time the value of x is 7.5, which matches with this else if condition, which is x is greater than or equal to 7. That's why it is executed this line of code and printed A onto the console. Now we're gonna change the value of x and try to execute again. Now this time we're gonna assign the value 9 and save and compile and run this. We have compiled the program. Now we're gonna run this. This time the output is O, because this time the first condition is matched, which says the value of x is greater than equal 9, which is true because the value of x is 9. That's why it is executed that block of code and printed O onto the console. Now we're gonna assign value 0 to x and try to compile and run this. The output is fail. In this case none of the conditions are met because the value of x is 0. That's why it is executed the default block at the end and printed the string fail onto the console. So the mechanism of else if ladder is, all of these conditions are checked from top to bottom. Whenever any of the conditions are met, then the corresponding block of code is executed, and after that the control exits the else if letter. When none of the conditions are met, then the code we write in the else block will be executed, and which is also called the default block. So hope you understand the concept. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.